number of rows equal to n. Number of rows equal to number of columns. Okay, we can find the determinant of a square matrix only. So then, if you find the determinant of a matrix A, you will get a scalar quantity. Okay, right? Is it not? Is it not?
Yes, ma'am.
Is you will get a scalar quantity. That's so geometrically the determinant gives us the volume of a box. Okay, volume of a box. If you consider a box, so you the determinant that rows will give us the dimensions of the edges. Okay, so determinant of that matrix will give us the volume of a box, right? So and the rows are linear. Linear property holds good in the first row. Generally, it is in the first row. Now, okay, can you tell me what is the determinant of the identity matrix?
One, ma'am.
One always. Okay, determinant of a identity matrix is always one. So identity matrix means 1 0 0 1. It is of second order, so it is not minus 1, it is plus 1. Okay, third order 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, so if you find the determinant of this identity matrix, you will get the value as 1. Okay, that means the cubic the volume of a cubic box of the dimension 1 is what? Length into breadth into height. 1, right? It is 1. Okay. Determinant will give us the volume of a box geometrically. So now we are going to discuss the properties of the determinants. What are the properties of the determinant? It is also one of the property. Determinant of a identity matrix is 1. Okay. So next. So to discuss about the properties. So generally I will consider the second order matrix. It is same for the higher order also of the square matrix. So for the simplicity, I am considering the second order matrix. So now first property. Okay. First property. So I am considering the determinant A. The first property is that determinant of a identity matrix is 1. So second property, the determinant changes sign when two rows are exchanged. For example, we have a determinant. I am considering the second order determinant A, B, C, D. Okay, what is the determinant of that? This, how to find the determinant of this? Product of principal diagonal minus product of the secondary diagonal. That is AD minus what? AD minus what is the determinant of this matrix?
Yes, AB minus.
AD,
AD
minus.
AB.
Let's watch.
AD minus. Except Varshita, nobody is in the class. BC or CP, correct? AD minus BC. So second property says that if you interchange any two rows, the determinant value will take the negative sign, opposite sign. So now I am going to interchange the row. First row and second row I am interchanging. CD, AB. Now find the determinant of this. What's the determinant of this now?
CB minus AD.
Yes, CB or BC we can consider. BC minus AD. BC minus AD. Now I will take the minus common. It become AD minus BC. Correct? So suppose if it is the determinant value of this matrix is suppose 5, what you will get determinant if you change this two rows, if you interchange these two rows, what you will get the determinant value?
Minus 5.
Minus 5. That is the second property of the determinants. Come to the third property. So third property, the determinant changes sign when two columns are exchanged. The same thing will happen if you interchange two columns. So first column is AC. First column is AC, AC. Second column is BD. So if you interchange this BD, AC. So now what is this? BC What's the determinant value? BC minus?
BC minus AD.
BC minus AD. So if the determinant of this AB, CD is 5, so if you interchange these two columns, you will get minus 5. Is it right? So minus of this one, right? Minus of, if you take minus comma,
yes,
minus of AD minus BC. Same thing with the opposite sign. So this is a third property what we have in the determinants. Come to the fourth property. If any two rows of a matrix A are equal, then its determinant value will be what?
Zero.
Zero, obviously. This is already you studied in your PU 11 itself. If any two rows of a determinants are same, then the determinant value will be zero. So first row will be AB. If second row is also same as AB. Now find the determinant. AB minus AB. What is AB minus AB?
Zero.
Zero. Okay. So the fourth property says that if any two rows of a determinant is same, then the determinant value will be zero. Come to the fifth property. So fifth property says that if a matrix A has as a row of zeros, then that means the determinant, if it contains any zero row, then the determinant value will be what?
Zero.
Zero. Zero into D is zero, minus zero into C is zero. That is zero. Okay. That means any determinant which contains the zero row, then the determinant value will be zero. Right? Come to the sixth property. So sixth property says that subtracting a multiple of one row from the another row leaves the same determinant. Okay, we did know row transformations. Row transformations, we did know in Gauss elimination method and all. Right? So that means if you do any row transformation, the determinant value will not change. So here I consider the determinant of A as A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. So now I am changing first row as, first row is changed as first row minus some x times second row. Some x times second row. So this will be equivalent to, so first row is changed as minus first row minus x times the second row. Is it right, the transformation?
Yes, ma'am.
B minus what? B minus?
XC.
XC now?
D.
XD. D. No change in the second row. I am not changing the second row. Only first row is changed as first row minus X times the second row. Now find the determinant of this. Okay, can you tell me the determinant of this? What's the determinant of the original determinant?
AD minus CB.
AD minus BC. Okay, now find the transformation what we did for the determinant. Now find the determinant value for that. Product of these two minus product of these two. That is A minus XC into D minus B minus XD into C. Okay, now simplify this. AD minus X into CD minus BC. Minus into minus plus x into what? X into?
CD.
CD. So these two terms cancel, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what we obtain? AD minus?
BC.
BC. It is same as, it is same as the original determinant value, correct? The determinant
yes,
value
ma'am.
Will not alter if you do the transformation for the rows. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next. Come to the seventh property. So, because properties are very important for you, based on properties, there are problems we are going to discuss. Okay? So, in your exams, they also ask problems on your properties also. If you know properties well, then problems will be easy for you. Okay? Yes, are you getting?
Yes, ma'am.
Come to the seventh property. Come to the seventh property. The seventh property says, okay, I will change the page. So these things are important for your GATE exams also. You can see the GATE syllabus. So in GATE syllabus, it is there. Determinants, linear algebra and all. Okay. Now come to the seventh property. Seventh property says the determinant depends. Seventh property, I will send the notes, okay? If you want, you can point out. So point in your, you make a point in your notebook. So you can write briefly. Today I will send the notes. After that, you can copy the notes. The determinant.
And fifth model notes you have sent already, ma'am.
I have sent. Again, I am writing topic wise. Then I will send the notes topic wise also, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So that whole thing I sent. So for your reference, if you write topic wise, if I am sending the notes, means it is easy for you to copy in your notebook. If you copy the notes once it is completed in the class, it will be easy for you to understand and remember. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So every day after completion of the topic, I will send the notes. Please copy in your notebook. So when your offline class starts, I will check your notes. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The determinant depends linearly on the first row. On the first row means linearity means, so addition subtraction will be done for the first row. The determinant value mainly depends on, so what we are doing, addition or subtraction in the first row. Linearity property means addition and subtraction, what you are doing for the first row. So that mainly the determinant value depends on that. So for example, so I am taking the addition, then I am doing the addition operation for the linearity property for the first row. So now I am going to add A dash and B dash. A dash for the first element and B dash for the second element. A, B, C, D. Okay, we have A, B, C, D as a determinant values, determinant elements. So for the first element, I am going to add A dash, and for the second element, I am going to add B dash. Okay. So now it can be written as A, B, C, D, determinant of A, B, C, D plus determinant of, what you will get? Determinant of A dash, B dash, C, D. You can check this determinant whether it is holds good or not. If you add the elements to the first row, okay, if you split this one, so a determinant of this value will be same as sum of the determinants of these two. Okay, this is a seventh property. And also we can do for multiplication also. If you multiply first row by x, that is ax, bx. If you multiply first row by x, ax, bx, cd, no change in the second row. This is same as x into the determinant of a, b, c, d. So that is determinant of 2a. Determinant of 2a is what? 2 times? Determinant of a. Okay. Determinant of 2a means I am multiplying 2 to the first row. So you can keep 2 outside. So determinant of 2a will be same as 2 times determinant of a. Did you clear the property?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is for multiplication, linearity property, and this is for addition. Similarly for subtraction also. So next we'll go for the eighth property. So eighth property says that if a matrix A, eighth property says that if a matrix A is triangular, then its determinant is equal to the product of its diagonal element. So triangular means upper triangular or lower triangular. If you consider a determinant with the upper triangular or lower triangular, for example A, B, 0, D, it is which type of matrix, which type of determinant? Which type of determinant it is?
Triangular.
Triangular. Upper triangular or lower triangular?
Upper. No.
Upper triangular determinant. What is this value? We will check it. So AD minus 0 into B is 0. So that is AD. Okay. So if it is a triangular matrix, triangular determinant, whether it is upper triangular or lower triangular, the value will be the product of its determinant. Sorry, product of its diagonal elements A into D. Okay, that will give us a determinant value. Directly, instead of simplifying to get the determinant value, if it is upper triangular or lower triangular, if you multiply the diagonal elements, that will be our determinant value. Clear the eighth property?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay, come to the ninth property. So because we are using all these properties, if I ask, you people should be ready to answer for it. Ninth property. So if the determinant of A is 0, then the matrix is said to be what? If the
null
determinant
matrix
of a matrix is null matrix, the determinant of a matrix A is 0, then the matrix is said to be singular matrix, correct? Huh? Did you remember singular matrix?
Yes, ma'am.
Singular matrix means its determinant value will be, for the singular matrix, what is the determinant value of a singular matrix?
0.
0. Okay, for non-singular matrix, in finding the inverse, you remembered that. So if you want to find the inverse of a matrix, it should be non-singular, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
For a singular matrix, determinant of a matrix is 0. Okay. So if so did you hear invertible matrix? Invertible. So invertible matrix means determinant A not equal to 0. Invertible matrix. For invertible matrix, determinant A not equal to 0. It is also called as non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix. Only for non-singular matrix you can find the inverse. For a singular matrix you cannot find the inverse, because what is the formula to find A inverse? 1 by determinant A into
adjoint
A. If determinant A is 0, so that is infinity, you will get A inverse. A inverse cannot be infinity. For that, only for non-singular matrix you can find the inverse. For the singular matrix you cannot find the inverse. Next, come to the third property. So third property says that, so it is also one of the important property, the determinant of product of two matrices, that is determinant of AB is same as determinant A into determinant B. Okay, I should remember this one. Determinant of AB is equal to determinant A into determinant B. So next, come to the 11th property. 11th property says that the transpose of a matrix A has the same determinant value that of A. The transpose, if you do the transpose of a matrix A, then if you find the determinant, it is same as the determinant of A. Okay, you have to remember this, we are using in the problems. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next, come to the 12th property. 12th property says that determinant of A inverse, determinant of A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant A. 1 by determinant A. Right? These are the important properties of the determinants. So we can verify these determinants by taking the second order determinant. It is easy for us to prove. Okay. So did you clear all the 12 properties? Did you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next. Next one note I am going to give you. Note permutation of a matrix. So you are going to use this in the identity matrix. Okay. So permutation of a matrix. Suppose I is the identity matrix. I is the identity matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay. Permutation of this identity matrix is represented by, so like this, P, and it is obtained by exchanging any two rows in the identity matrix. So somewhere we are using the permutation of the matrix. Permutation of a matrix is obtained by interchanging any two rows of the identity matrix only, of the identity matrix. So now I am interchanging first and second row, 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, permutation of this identity matrix will be this one. So interchanging of any two rows in the identity matrix will give us permutation of a matrix. The determinant, so directly we can find the determinant of the permutation matrix by using the formula minus 1 to the power of n. This is a formula we are using to find the determinant of the permutation matrix. Permutation matrix is a matrix. It is obtained by interchanging any two rows of the identity matrix. Is all of you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Varshita, how many were there in the class?
44, ma'am.
44 were there. All 44 were there, or just they on their I think physically their mobile is present for the class. I think mentally students were not there. Physical presentation of the mobile, I think, not for the students, right?
So
from today onwards, I will call the names, then I will take the attendance. Just I will not download the attendance sheet. So then only I will get to know how many were present in the class.
Yes, ma'am.
That's better, Alva. Okay, next. I will go for the problems. So you can, whether I sent that model question papers to you?
No, ma'am.
You don't have model question papers, right?
One sir sent, ma'am. You said you'll send another two.
Yes, sir. Today I will send two model question papers and along with the notes of the today's class. Okay.
Yes,
so in the model question paper, they asked reduce the matrix A to, okay, right? Upper triangle matrix we have to do. Okay, eigenvalues they are given. Find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors, they are given for 6 marks. So already we did eigenvalues and eigenvectors, they asked for 6 marks. And diagonalization of a matrix A, and hence find A power 4. So they asked this question for 8 marks. So just I will tell that before going to the problems on this. So in model question paper 2, they asked the question, diagonalize the matrix and hence find A to the power of 4. A to the power of 4 we have to find. So they are given the matrix A as 1, 6, 1, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3. This is a matrix what they are given. It is for 8 marks. Okay. Diagonalize the matrix. To find the diagonalization, first we have to consider determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. Characteristic equation, right? Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
We have to find the characteristic equation, this one. Since it is a third order, you will get cubic equation in lambda. Like a into lambda cube plus b into lambda square plus c into lambda plus d equal to 0. Like this you will get. Since it is a third order, third degree equation, you will get three values for lambda. Say lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, you will get. So next we have to consider the simultaneous equations by considering a minus lambda I into x equal to 0. You will get three equations. Correct? Is it not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So next come to the case 1. In case 1, put lambda is equal to lambda 1 in equation, in this set of equations. You can call this as system 1. Okay, put lambda is equal to lambda 1 in the system 1. You will get the three equations with the x, y, z. So consider two equations, any two equations which are not same, then use the Cramer's rule. X by the determinant is equal to minus y by the determinant is equal to z by the determinant. Consider any two not same equations, then use the Cramer's rule, then find the values for x, y, z. So that will give us first eigenvector. Okay, these values of lambda are called eigenvalues, and find out the eigenvector. Next come to case 2. So in case 2, put lambda is equal to lambda 2 in the system 1. You will get again three equations with x, y, z. Now consider any two non-same equations, okay, not equal equations. The two equations should not be same. So then use the Cramer's rule again for two different equations. Again you find x, y, z values. So that will give us second eigenvector value. Okay. Next, come to the case 3. In case 3, put lambda is equal to lambda 3 in the system of equations 1. So you will get three equations with three unknowns. Consider two different equations out of three equations. Again, use Cramer's rule for two different equations here also. This is the formula what we have. Okay, find out the x3, that is third eigenvector, x, y, z values. After finding this, construct the model matrix P such that first column will be x1 value, this value, x1 value, second column will be x2 value, third column will be x3 value. After constructing the model matrix P, now find out P inverse. So directly you can find P inverse using your calculator. Okay. You can find P inverse directly using your calculator. So after finding P inverse, next consider P inverse AP. Multiplication of three matrices. P inverse A into P. You will get a matrix that will be diagonal matrix. For example, so lambda 1, 0, 0, 0, lambda 2, 0, 0, 0, lambda 3. Okay. So your diagonal elements of that diagonal matrix will be your eigenvalues. Okay, this is a method we are using to diagonalize the given matrix. After finding the diagonalization, in this question they are asking us to find the A power 4. Are you getting?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We have to find the, we have to construct A power 4 by using diagonalization. How to construct A power 4? Okay, so already we got the diagonal matrix D as P inverse AP. Right? So this we got it as lambda 1, 0, 0, 0, lambda 2, 0, 0, 0, lambda 3. Okay, this is the value for P inverse AP. As we know that P inverse AP will be our diagonal matrix. So next to find the powers of A, so you I am constructing the formula. So then you can use only the formula directly. So P inverse, okay. So here what I am going to do, I want a square. For that, a square means, so here we have, 1 minute. So here, pre multiply by p, p into p inverse, here also pre multiply by p. So p into p inverse is I into a, okay, I into a into p is equal to p inverse d, okay. So next, I into a is a itself into p is equal to p inverse d. Post multiply by p inverse, post multiply by p inverse. So p inverse d, 1 minute, here p inverse, right, it is not p inverse, it is p. Pre multiply by p on both side, pre multiply by p on both side. Now post multiply by p inverse on both side, it is p and it is p inverse, post multiply. This is pre multiply. So p into p inverse will be I, p d p inverse. Okay, I into a is a itself, a is equal to p d p inverse we got. Okay, I want a square. A square means p d p inverse into what? P d p inverse, a into a, this into this again. So p d, I am grouping these two, p inverse p into d into p inverse. What is p into p inverse?
I.
I. Okay, it is I d p inverse. What is I into d?
D.
D itself. Okay, d into d?
D square.
D square. So a square. A square is equal to p d square p inverse. P d square p inverse. Okay. So this is easy for us to find d square instead of finding a square. How to find d square? So that is p, the model matrix p, you write, substitute. D square means, already we know that d square means lambda 1, d is lambda 1, 0, 0, 0, lambda 2, 0, 0, 0, lambda 3, okay na? D square means just squares for the diagonal elements, that's it, into p inverse, p inverse already we found. So multiply these three matrices, you will get a square. So if you want, now we want a power 4. How to find a power 4? We have to multiply a, the matrix a, 4 times. Instead of that, you consider the matrix p. This is a way we have to use to find a power 4 by using the diagonal matrix. Okay, this is a matrix p, you substitute third order matrix. Then a power 4, that means here d power 4, correct? D power 4, right? Lambda 1 power 4, 0, 0,
yes, 0,
lambda 2 power 4. 0, 0, 0, lambda 3 power 4 into p inverse. P inverse we already formed. Now multiply these three matrices using your calculator, that will give us a to the power of 4. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is the way we have to diagonalize them. We have to first find eigenvalues, then eigenvectors, then the diagonalization, then finding the powers of a. Okay, this is the way we have to follow. Next. Okay, we will come back to the determinants. Come back to the determinants. So this is a problem. So it is also asked in the model question paper. Model question paper 2 itself. Okay, model question paper 2 itself for 5 marks. So the question is that if a 4 cross 4 matrix has the determinant of A is 1 by 2. Then find the following. First one, this is a 5 marks question. Determinant of, 2A. Second question, determinant of minus A. Third question, determinant of A square. Fourth question, determinant of A inverse. Now this is what we have to find. So come to the solution. First you write down the data given. What is the data given? What is the data given?
4 cross 4 matrix.
4 cross 4 matrix means what is the order? Order of a matrix?
4.
Order of a matrix is 4. Okay. Next, what is given in the question?
Determinant A equals to 1 by 2.
Determinant A is equal to 1 by 2. So these are the two data given in the question. By making use of these two data, we have to find out these values. Okay, come to the first one. So how to find determinant of 2A? As I told in the property.
2 into determinant A.
Yes, very good. Determinant of 2A is equal to 2 into determinant A. What is determinant A?
1 by 2.
Determinant A is 1 by 2. So 2 to cancel. What is the determinant of 2A?
1.
Okay. Let's come to the second one. So determinant of minus A. How to find determinant of minus A?
So minus determinant A.
Minus determinant A. That's also correct. In generally, we can take this as minus 1 to the power of n into the determinant A. Okay, determinant of minus A will depends on the order of the determinant. Okay, did you clear? It depends on order of the determinant. Okay, instead of using this one, so determinant of minus A will be minus 1 to the power of n into A. Suppose we have, okay, so the matrix A, B, C, D. So here we have minus, 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 minus. So if you take minus common from the first row, minus 1, okay. If you take minus common in the second, it become what? Minus into minus.
Plus.
Plus. Minus into minus, plus. That is minus 1 to the power of 2 into, after taking minus common, so minus 1 into minus 1 into what we left with the determinant? A, B, C, D, right? Is it right?
Yes, ma'am.
So since it is the second order, we have a negative minus A. So with minus A means all the terms with minus. So I took minus common from the first row and minus common from the second row. Minus into minus, that is minus 1 power 2 into the determinant of the matrix A. Is it right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, similarly, so it is the formula we are using to find the determinant of minus A, that is minus 1 to the power of n into determinant A. What is n given here? What is the order of the matrix?
4.
4. Minus 1 to the power of 4 into, what is the determinant of A?
1 by 2.
What is minus 1 power 4?
1.
1 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. Did you clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So this cannot be written. Minus determinant A is wrong. Okay, minus determinant A is wrong. You will not get. So by concept of this one, you may get minus 1 by 2, but minus 1 by 2 is not correct. Correct, no? Did you clear, Varshita?
Yes, ma'am.
Come to the third one. Third one. Determinant of A square. How to find determinant of A square by knowing determinant of A? You can use the property. Determinant of A square can be written as? Anybody? What is determinant of AB?
Determinant of A into determinant A.
Determinant of A into?
Determinant A into determinant B.
Similarly, determinant of A square, instead of B, we have A, correct? Determinant of
determinant
A square
A into determinant A.
Yes, determinant A into determinant A. What is determinant A?
1 by 2.
1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is what?
1 by 4.
1 by 4. Next, come to the fourth one. So determinant of A inverse. Already I gave the formula in the property itself. What is the determinant of A inverse?
1 by determinant A.
1 by determinant A. That is 1 by 1 by 2. What is 1 by 1 by 2? 1 by 1 by 2? Denominator of the denominator is multiplied to the numerator, 2, right? Did you clear? Is all of you clear? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay, this is a way, this is the problem. We solved it by using the properties of the determinants. Okay, in the next class, we will go for the which concept? Upper triangular matrix. How to reduce the given matrix to the upper triangular matrix. That we will discuss in the next class. Okay? Tomorrow, Saturday, right? Saturday, I am going to take the special class for your paper. Okay? We have a lot to do. We have short of time. At the end, I cannot cover the syllabus. For that, from the